joint. Right now that's standing room only that way. But that's where the ventilation is.
Thank you. Oops. I'm sorry. I don't know. Yeah, what's the bed?
Let's go over there.
Yeah, sure. Oh. Yeah, let's go. Go.
Watch your step on the frog.
Oops.
I have your attention, please, for a short but important pitch announcement. Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, welcome aboard the Sacramento 7 Railroad. We're pleased to have you aboard today. We look forward to making this an enjoyable experience. We recommend that you stay seated during the trip, but if you need to move about, you take hold of the handrails in the open gondola cars or the seat backs in the coaches and first-class observation car. We ask that you hold on to small children during the trip. Please do not let them stand embedded on the train. Others will fall water. That help you board the train are your car attendants, and there's at least one attendant in every car. Their function is to look out for your safety and to answer your questions. We are now leaving Old Sacramento, once the bustling commercial area of the city and the gateway to the gold country. In the late 1840s through the 1950s, ocean-going ships and steam-powered paddle wheels made their way between San Francisco and Sacramento, carrying freight and passengers. By the mid-1850s, Sacramento was rapidly growing into a prosperous city, serving the needs of miners to the east and swelling immigrant population flocking to. A company will soon form here in Sacramento called the Central Pacific Railroad. It began construction of the western port of the Transcontinental Railway in 1863. The very first spike for this great railroad was struck at Front Bay Street by the boardwalk that today leads to the Delta King. The project was completed when a gold spike was struck in Trolley Delta on May 10, 1869. California and the West were finally open and ready for rapid expansion. During World War II, nearly 7,000 workers were employed. Fish, carpenters, grass, automakers.
Yeah, I see.
All found their employees in the Sacramento. During the first 2 decades of the 20th century, California, where Harvard was a growing state, not by many in the East to be a better place to live. That way, California and our western state became easily accessible to all. By 1900, 31 years after the completion of the first transcontinental railroad, the Southern Pacific had become the dominant railroad in California. The ST had become the main means of transportation in the state. The wide-body line now of the city of the Southern Pacific, called the Sacramento Southern Railroad. Further south, as far as Freeport, it was here in 1900 that the Summer Olympic Swimming Trials were held in the Sacramento. Thank you. now returning to the depot in Old Sacramento. Please take a look around you and make sure that you have all of your belongings. When the train comes to a stop, it will take a few moments to uncouple the locomotive. Once that is completed, your car attendant will give the signal to disembark from the train. Please exit the same way that you entered. And please watch your step on the way down. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the California State Railroad Museum and your all-volunteer crew, it has been our sincere. Enjoy the rest of your day here in Old Sacramento, and please join us again soon.
Thanks for riding with us today. Bye.
Thank you.
There's that C again. We'll see you later, guys.
Sure, we'll come back.